April Ordaway, page 208. Quick, look at her cute and says, her quirk for the bicker she lives, the slicker she grows. Save us and tag us, no more. Where in worth did you ever pick up a lamb body chop as big as a battering ram? Aye, you're right, I ebb to forgetting, like Livium Little did Lavern Long. The length of my hue, I say. She wore plowboy's nail-studded clogs, a pair of plow fields in themselves, a sugarloaf hat and a gaudy quivery peak, and a band of gorse for an adornment, and 100 streamers dancing off it, and a gilded pin to pierce it. Owl glassy bicycles boggled her eyes, and a fitch shovel for the sun not to spoil the wrinklings of her hydrous specs. Potato rings buckled the loose loops of her log snars. A nude cube of stockings were salmon spot speckled. She sported a galago shimmy of sapier tinto that never was fast till it ran in the washing. Stout stays, the rivals, lined her length. Her blood-orange black knickers, a two-in-one garment, showed natural boggers, fancy-fasted, free to undo. Her black-striped tan Joseph was sequin-sewn and teddy bear-lined, with wavy rush-green epaulettes and a lee down here in a royal swan strap. A pace of Gasper struck her hay-rope garters. Her civvy corduroy coat with buttons were bounded round with a two-board tunnel belt, a four-penny bit in which pocket side weighed her safe from the blow-away wind rush. She had a closed peg tied aside her jockey's nose, and she kept on grinding something quaint in her fumy mouth, and wreck of the foove of the tail of the gone of her swuff-drift skirt trailed 50-odd Irish miles behind her linger hodes. Hell's bells, I'm sorry I missed her. Sweet grumpy tum and nobody fainted. But in whelk of her mouse was her nasal light. Everyone that saw her said she doused little Delia looked a bit queer. Lotsy trotsy, mind the pottle. Missus, be good and don't fall in the say. Finny, poor hex, she must have charred. Kickums or frumpier ever she saw. Making mush mullet's eyes at her boys Dublon. And they crowned her that Cheriton queen, all the maids. Of the May, you don't say. Well, for her, she couldn't see herself. I reckons wherefore the darling married her mere. She did? Mercy me, there's a curious of droth-stropping surface men, bloom-slinging and plug-chewing, fruit-eyeing and flower-feeding.